When it comes time for New Year's Eve, you'll be prepared to play something special. This is because you clicked on this video. Here's another reasonably challenging arrangement based upon chord melody, and it also helps that it sounds really fantastic when played exactly right, and I'm going to show you how. So first thing, put down your D chord and roll up your sleeve, as I always say. Put down a D chord, and you're first picking the third string, the downstroke. Then you're playing strings 5, 4, 3, 2. Then back to the third string. Then the second string. Okay, got that part? Now you have to play the second fret, then a string. So that's all done by holding down that D chord. But now we switch to the A chord and we strum all five strings that you normally would. So how do you sort of transition between the two? Start off with that. I guess you mute a little bit. Second string, then open. Now here's an interesting move where you do a pull-off, but you do it with the ring finger. Second fret, then a string. Make your D chord again and strum 5, 4, 3, 2. Play the second string again. And now you still hold down your D chord, but now you strum all five strings for that sound. Now you play another version of the D chord here by going 5, 7, 7, index on the thinnest string, ring on the 7th fret, 3rd string, pinky on the 7th fret, 2nd string, going like this, 3 strings, and you make a D chord shape where these two fingers here, index and middle, are now on the 7th fret. And I wanted to mention, you'll notice that a lot with this little switch between those two shapes in this exact spot in different orders. All right, so that's the first section you can think about. Now you hit this thinnest string again while you hold that, and you switch back to it, like I said. Hit this second string twice, then the third string. A little muting, make your A chord. Second string. Pull off again, make the D chord, inside strings, open, second string, make a G chord, and you play all strings except the second string. Now here you have to be precise. Middle finger goes to the second fret, third string, open, second string now, and then you make a D chord. Once again, you play the inside strings. So that would be the second line. So now we have to jump all the way to the 7th fret with the ring finger. Then a string. Then you quickly go back into this shape. 5, 7, 7, you can think of it. 7, 7 on the 2nd string. 3rd string. Got that part? So you're jumping here, you're going. And you put it down. There's a little muting there. 7, 7, boom. Now this is all on the 2nd fret now, your A chord. B string, open. Here's this again. Put it down once more. 7, 7, 5. Making that D chord shape now, like I said, where your ring where your ring winds up. On the 8th fret, 2nd string, and your 1st and 2nd finger are on the 7th fret, and you go like this. Now here's something interesting. While you keep that shape, you hit it one more time. And by the way, I want to point something out. I'm going to back up, because there's a certain point where there's upstrokes. I want to show you that. So you go to this, you make it upstroke here, then down. I want to make sure you know that. Okay, so, well, let's just go through that one more time then. So you jump here, you play three strings, up, up, down, A chord. Jump over here, make this shape, D chord shape, and you rake it just like that, evenly. Hit it again with the upstroke, and I go 5-7-7, 7-7, boom, just like before. Down your D chord and strum the inside strings. Open second string, make a G chord, play everything except the thinnest string. For that sound, second fret, third string. Open second string. End it by playing strings 5, 4, 3, 2. Nice even strumming on that. So it's important to notice the timing of this, you know. Remember upstrokes, A chord. So once you get to this, you play the open second string. This G chord goes down. But you have to pause for a second. You go, pause again.